Welcome back to Apple Addiction. In the past few years though, there have been many iPhone devices that have been announced in September, but appeared 1 or 2 months later, with the iPhone X arrived in November 2017, while the iPhone XR coming in October 2018. Due to COVID-19, we also saw the iPhone 12 delayed until October, but if things return to normality, then we would expect the iPhone 13 will release in September 2021. So in this video, we are going to tell you about iPhone 13 mini, everything you need to know. The video is going to be amazing, so make sure you stick till the end. We already know that the 12 was a super cycle, so the design of the 13 will more than likely stay the same, and the A15 chip won't give us a huge bump in performance since it's still using the 5-nanometer architecture. But if you really care about the 120Hz refresh rate, a smaller notch, or the flurry of camera upgrades now coming to the entire iPhone 13 lineup, then iPhone 13 is the one for you. If rumors are true, then Apple fans will have a lot to look forward to in the iPhone 13. Ultra-wide camera. There is a very exciting rumor. Barclays reported that every iPhone 13 model is expected to come with an upgraded ultra-wide camera with significantly improved low-light performance. The new rumors are pointing that Apple switching to an f1.8 aperture, which is slightly worse than the f1.6 aperture on the wide lens, which is excellent for low lights. But f1.8 is extremely impressive for an ultra-wide lens, and this will greatly help for camera quality. Now you may have noticed that basically all of those have to do with camera performance, and that's because the iPhone 12 was a super cycle. And Apple usually focuses on camera upgrades the following year, so there's a good chance that we're going to see all of those upgrades happen. Now, within the same report from Barclays, they also mentioned that the 2.5x zoom lens that's currently exclusive to the 12 Pro Max will likely come down to the 13 Pro model. Wi-Fi 6E. Another line of wide rumor came back in December when Barclays reported that the iPhone 13 will come with support for Wi-Fi 6E, which is very important because it uses a brand new 6 GHz band, which leads to better performance, lower latency, and faster data rates. The executive chip maker at Broadcom even mentioned that this will be the most disruptive boon for Wi-Fi users in the last 20 years. And this rumor was confirmed once again in January, so there's a good chance we should see it in the iPhone 13 lineup. Smaller notch and Face ID. Another feature that everybody has been waiting for years is a smaller notch, and it looks like it just might happen in the iPhone 13. Way back in October, Ice Universe on Twitter claimed that the iPhone 13 will have a shorter notch, and then he posted SketchUp to show how it'll change. So that's very exciting, because the notch has stayed the same for years. And then, about a month ago, Mac Odakara also reported that the iPhone 13 will have a thinner notch, because the receiver at the top of the display will move toward the edge of the case. This might actually mean that Apple will also upgrade the performance of Face ID as well, to make it faster, since it hasn't really been upgraded in years. And that's actually what we saw in some other leaks from DigiTimes, claiming that Face ID will get a new VCSEL chip, which reduces volume and improves depth sensing capabilities. So that's very exciting. LiDAR scanner. Another awesome feature that's rumored to be coming to the entire lineup is actually the LiDAR scanner that's currently only available on the iPhone 12 Pro models. It's honestly a game changer in terms of camera quality. In new models, portrait mode photos have been getting better and better, with the depth map being much more accurate in terms of the blur edging and also the depth of field effect as it gets further and further away from the foreground. Not only that, but it greatly helps with autofocusing for night mode photos, where the iPhone 11 Pro really struggled with focus hunting, and the 12 Pros no longer do that, thanks to LiDAR. So if LiDAR comes to every single iPhone 13, Apple's camera performance in general is going to skyrocket. Camera. The iPhone 13, which some people actually believe will be called the iPhone 12S. The iPhone 13 lineup will most likely stay the same with 4 different models. However, there have been many recent reports that the iPhone 12 mini has been performing the worst in terms of sales. People believe that the design of the new iPhone 13 lineup will be unchanged. Looking practically identical to the 12 series, we might see a small change in terms of the camera bump or something like that, but don't expect any major changes. DigiTimes claimed that the new sensor shift stabilization that's currently available on only the iPhone 12 Pro Max is going to be coming to the entire iPhone 13 lineup. If the entire iPhone 13 lineup gets this, that would be awesome for those people who don't want to get the Pro model. And it would likely mean that the sensor itself would be improved as well, like it is on the top Pro Max. And another publication, ET News, also reported the same thing. so there's a good chance that this could happen. Portless iPhone. And now we have the next rumor, which is perhaps the most controversial of all. Way back in December of 2019, Ming-Chi Kuo reported that Apple would launch an iPhone without a Lightning port in 2021, saying that it would only be the highest-end model, which will be the 13 Pro Max. A few months later, John Prosser basically said the same thing, one portless iPhone coming in 2021. And then on top of that, there were a bunch of patents that Apple applied for showing off a new connector for the iPhone, replacing the Lightning ports. And there was even one that looks like a magnetic MagSafe wired connector. On top of that, we do see some leaks from Fudge claiming that the 2021 iPhone will have some sort of smart connector replacing Lightning, which will use magnets to charge. But other than that, we haven't really seen much else about Apple ditching Lightning, so there's a chance that it might not happen this year. Vapor chamber thermal systems. The next rumor is actually very interesting. Ming-Chi Kuo reported that the Apple is aggressively testing vapor chamber thermal systems for the iPhone. This basically involves a heat pipe filled with water that evaporates to help cool the chip better than a regular heat sink. This is extremely important because the current A14 chip in the iPhone 12 is already being throttled in terms of performance. We know this because the same exact A14 chip in the much larger iPad Air 4 is able to stay cool, and it performs much better in terms of graphics power. So this shows that the iPhone is currently hitting a performance wall, which is really bad for the iPhone 13. So Apple absolutely needs better cooling if they want to continue improving performance. Touch ID. Getting even more exciting, way back in October, the reliable leaker Love to Dream tweeted out that Mesa UTS is coming to the iPhone, and then John Prosser translated UTS as under the screen Touch ID coming. Then in December, Ming-Chi Kuo also added to that rumor, saying that Apple is working on an iPhone with both Face ID and under-display Touch ID, which is likely the iPhone 13. And then in January, Mark Gurman from Bloomberg said that Apple is testing an in-screen fingerprint reader, and he's a very reliable leaker. And then it happened again. Joanna Stern from the Wall Street Journal said basically the same thing. So we can say this is looking more and more likely to happen, especially since an under-display fingerprint sensor was also rumored to be coming to this year's Apple Watch Series 7. 120Hz refresh rate. We've all been waiting years for Apple to bring a 120Hz refresh rate to the iPhone, and it looks like it's finally going to happen. Back in October, John Prosser reported that 120Hz was for sure coming to the 2021 Pro iPhones, since it almost made it onto the iPhone 12 Pro. But unfortunately, it didn't due to battery life concerns. And then in December, the analyst reported that 120Hz is finally coming to the iPhone 13 models, thanks to the adoption of LTPO OLED display technology. This is exciting because it would also allow for a variable refresh rate like Apple currently uses on the iPad Pro. And it would also allow for an always-on display, which would be greatly welcome on the iPhone. The ELEC also reported that 120Hz is coming to the Pro models, so it's looking like we should see this feature for sure. Let us know your opinion in the comments section below. This was all for today. Hope you liked the video. Do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Stay safe, and we will be back soon with another video.